So we all may have some ulterior motives. So if you have ulterior motives, what happens? The law doesn't come in our hearts. We may want to control, we may want to enjoy. Now, our ulterior motives don't stop God from loving us. Ram still loved Bharat. So, but what those ulterior motives do is that they stop us from experiencing God's love for us. So, although God always loves us, we can't experience His love if we have ulterior motives. If we have a desire to be powerful, to be famous, to be prosperous in this world. Now, yes, as somebody might be devoted, and maybe all these also. But if those are our primary driving desires, then God doesn't have place in our hearts. And then if that is what we want, He says, yes, you can have it. So it's important that to understand, is God's love conditional? Well, to understand this, we have to understand that there are two meanings of the word condition. Condition means demand. This is going to be a conditional peace. So, for example, two countries are fighting and one country is more powerful and it's winning. The conditional peace. As long as you satisfy these terms, we will hold ourselves back. So it's conditional peace. So condition can mean demand, but condition can also mean state. For example, if somebody is sick, we may ask, what is their condition now? So is God's love conditional in the sense of demand? No. He doesn't make any demand from us. Whether we love Him or not, He still loves us always. Now, His love is unconditional in that sense. We may have forgotten Him, but He doesn't forget us. He remains in our hearts, waiting for us to turn toward Him, working so that situations in our life are arranged in such a way that we turn to Him. So in that sense, His love for us is unconditional. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishto. Krishna says, He's in the hearts of everyone, not just in the hearts of the devoted. Prahlad Maharaj says that the Lord is Krupana Vatsala, not just Bhakta Vatsala. Not just the lover of the devotees, not just compassionate to the devotees, but Krupanas, even those who are miserly, those who are materialistic, those who have no interest in the Lord, even for them He is loving. So in that sense, His love is unconditional. In the sense that He doesn't make any demand from us before He will love us. But in the state, in the sense of state, that our heart has to be in a particular state to experience His love. So the sun gives light to everyone. In that sense, the sun's giving of light is unconditional. But if you consider that if we go into a dark dungeon, if our state is that we are not in the sunlight, our state is that we are in a dark dungeon, we cannot see the sun. So similarly, if the state of our heart is that we have filled it with other things and there is no place for God to come in, then there is no experience of, then we can't experience the Lord's love for us. So that in that sense, the Lord's love is both unconditional and conditional. Unconditional in terms of He always keeps loving us, but we can't experience His love if our heart is not in the receptive state. And receptive state means it's guileless. Now, guileless means we have no ulterior motives. Now, what if we have ulterior motives? Now, we may say, I am not that pure. I have so many other desires. Then we can still open our heart. Our heart is filled and locked so that God can't enter. But then we have the key. The key to open the heart is humility. Humility means even if our heart is not open because of love for the Lord, still it can be open because of humility. And we can humbly pray to the Lord. My dear Lord, I am not yet pure, but I want to be pure. Please purify me. My heart is dark. Please light my heart. And the Lord will indeed light it. So at our level, we can't have guilelessness in the presence of no ulterior motives. But even if we don't have guilelessness at that level, we can have guilelessness. We don't conceal our motives. We don't put on an act. That doesn't mean we go around and parade to the world that we are impure and we tell everyone about our impurities. It's just that we don't become proud, we don't become presumptuous, we don't become arrogant. We stay humble. So in a sense, humility is simply honesty. We are not at a very high level in our devotion, unless of course we are special souls and we are. But then even then, as an example for others, devotees are humble.